Get early access to these videos, plus extra content, and the chance to be a part of some of it, with advice Patreon asked for, or Patreon goes postal. Support Buckley at patreon.com/doseofbuckley. Now, we all know that Disney owns pretty much every form of entertainment. With its recent purchase of 20th Century Fox, they added to their roster that already included Marvel, Lucasfilm, ABC, ESPN. That's right, if you were watching sports, you were watching Disney. Hell, they own part of the History Network. They can literally present history however they want. But one thing Walt's company never cared that much about, it seems, is radio. Oh sure, since the mid-90s, Disney has owned Radio Disney, but it's amazing to me that they never tried to flat-out own SiriusXM or iHeartMedia. Maybe because they know radio's a sinking ship. Though that hasn't stopped them from keeping Star Wars, am I right, fanboys? You're all idiots. Anyway, Radio Disney is a very amusing station to me because, of course, it's meant for children, teens, and tweens, but their moral compass is, a little out of alignment, kind of pointing in all directions. Like all radio stations, they generally play edited versions of songs, but Radio Disney makes some really interesting choices. I recently did an autopsy of Taylor Swift's The Man. Radio Disney plays that song. But what about the part where she swears? Well, they probably just cut the lyrics, or Taylor Swift provided a clean version of the song to radio stations, right? No, instead, they do these horrible replacements. Instead of the "if I were out flashing my dollars, I'd be a bitch, not a baller," they changed it to "if I were out flashing my dollars, I'd be out flashing my dollars," with an extremely jarring, very noticeable edit. It's the type of shit that wouldn't even pass a year one production class in radio school. Also, it really insults the intelligence of children, which we'll get to in a little bit as well. Being Disney, you'd think that they'd have the power to even get Taylor Swift to provide a better version than that, but I guess since Taylor Swift is the man, she can tell old Mickey to blow her. And one thing they never seem to do is just mute the swear words. Why? Well, I guess they figure kids will go, "What happened to the lyrics there?" and ask questions. And we certainly don't want kids asking questions. Sometimes they're able to get artists to provide completely re-recorded versions of songs. Now, artists have done this for years anyway, without Disney being a part of it. Look at the Black Eyed Peas' Let's Get It Started for radio, as opposed to the Let's Get Retarded version on the album. Or Fergie's London Bridge, where the radio version says "Oh snap" over and over, but the original says "Oh shit." But Radio Disney has had artists make exclusive edits just for them. Meghan Trainor actually re-recorded All About That Bass just for Radio Disney, removing the references to "Shaking It," her "Boom Boom," and "All the Right Junk" in all the right places. Yeah, it's pretty clear, I ain't no size 2, but I'ma make it like I'm supposed to do. Cause I got them smooth moves, they say I look great. Be that star on all them big stages. It appears she may have done this again with her song "Nice to Meet Ya." I can't find this version anywhere else online, where she's changed the lyric "You don't know half of the shit that I've seen" with this. You don't know the half of the things that I've seen. There are two things that make me laugh about this one. One, if an artist is willing to re-record lyrics like this, why not just release the song this way anyway? You clearly don't care about artistic integrity or freedom of expression or whatever. You're re-recording it for an extra potential revenue stream. And second, let's pretend kids actually like this song. What are they gonna do when they want to hear it again and not have to wait for it to play on the radio? Well, they're gonna go to Spotify or YouTube to listen to it. And guess what? It's not edited there. Obviously, that's not Radio Disney's responsibility, but if parents are truly worried about their child being corrupted by hearing the word "shit," they've already heard it before, and they're gonna hear it again. Now, as I mentioned before, their moral compass is bizarre. They don't want swearing, of course, or anything too sexual, but then they play songs that mention being in the back seat. Like in the back seat, time stops. Laying in your back seat, time stops. What do you think they're doing back there? It ain't license plate bingo, and it definitely ain't I Spy. I spy with my little eye something that is hard. They also play Billie Eilish's Everything I Wanted, which has a lyric about suicide. Thought I could fly, so I stepped off the golden. Nobody cried. Nobody even noticed. Now I can tell you exactly what they're doing. Their standards and practices go, is a 12-year-old going to be able to figure this out? No. And would the parents even notice it while it's on? No. Well, then play it. But ultimately, shouldn't Disney be able to create like 12 pop stars and then write all of their lyrics and make them popular? This is Disney, the company that took Robert Downey Jr. from Simpsons and Basketball punchline to maybe the biggest star of the 2010s. Surely they could pay Demi Lovato, who they created in the first place, to sing a song that doesn't have any swearing or sexual references, or create a whole new group of pop stars that are just cool and edgy enough to be liked by teens and tweens without them alluding to getting fucked in the backseat of some dude's Civic. The other thing that makes me laugh? They're truly trying to live in a Disney fairy tale. Now, every radio station right now mentions the coronavirus like every fucking second a song isn't playing. Commercials mention it, their announcers talk about it, it's insanity. But Radio Disney, in 2 hours, didn't mention it once. And I would put money on the fact that they don't mention it at all. Here's a clip of them talking about rescheduled movies, without once mentioning why they were rescheduled. Just, here's some new release dates.
It's the Radio Disney Insider with Candace. All right, let's update you on some Disney movie news. New release dates for some of the much anticipated movies you were waiting on, I am sure. So we're going to start with Mulan, the live action version. So excited about this. Actually, I have friends who have already seen it and said that it is incredible. So you can see that starting July 24th. All right, let's move on to Marvel. If you're excited about Black Widow, that release date is now November 6th. Looking forward to that one.
I guess it's slightly better than them pretending that they were always the release dates. But any kids that are listening to Radio Disney, they're probably doing so from home because they don't have school. You don't think an 8-year-old knows why they aren't at school or why a Marvel movie that was supposed to come out in May is now coming out in November? Again, it just insults the intelligence of their audience. But I guess it does what it's supposed to do. Lulls parents into a false sense of security that they've made the right choice by putting it on Radio Disney, and they can say, I've done some great parenting today. Because that's the real target audience of Radio Disney. It's not the kids. Kids don't want to hear this shit. They want to hear regular, uncensored pop and rap music. And they already are on YouTube and Spotify. No, the audience is naive parents who actually believe for a second that they can protect their kids from hearing a big bad swear word or learning that sometimes it's a fucked up world after all.